Certifications are becoming a very important currency to hold. In the current state of the cloud, customers are so in need to get high-skilled professionals. Having a certification becomes an obvious asset and stamp to have. Hey guys, I'm Shubham from Intellipaat. In today's video, we're going to discuss about AZ-103 certification. So, without wasting more time, let's get started. First, we're going to discuss how AZ-103 came into existence. If this change came into the picture, there must be a reason for it. After that, why you should opt for AZ-103 certification, the prerequisites required for AZ-103 certification, then most importantly, we will also discuss about the exam objective, its pattern, and in the end, how you should prepare for AZ-103 exam. How AZ-103 came into existence. So guys, previously Azure had launched two new role-based certifications, that is AZ-100 and AZ-101, as a replacement of 7535 for the Microsoft Azure Administrator role. But recently on May 1st, 2019, both the AZ-100 and 101 exams got retired and replaced by AZ-103 exam. So if one is willing to become a Microsoft certified Azure administrator, then they should focus on AZ-103 exam preparation. That is how it came into existence. So all of a sudden transition from AZ-100 and 101 towards a new AZ-103 certification? There must be a reason behind this change, right? That we shall discuss as we move forward. So guys, in the early stages of the Microsoft certified Azure Administrator Associate certification, Microsoft Learning received a lot of negative feedbacks about the new AZ-100 and 101 exams being very difficult for people to crack. Based on the feedbacks, they decided to combine the AZ-100 and 101 certification exams into a single AZ-103 certification exam, that is Microsoft Azure Administrator certification exam. The combined AZ-103 exam is not merely a merging of the full AZ-100 and AZ-101 certification exam. The AZ-103 exam pulls in approximately 70% of its objectives from the AZ-100 exam and approximately 30% of its objectives from the AZ-101 exam. As a result of the transition, the AZ-100 and 101 certification exams are now retired as of May 1, 2019 and are no longer be able to scheduled or be taken. Additionally, the transition exam AZ-102 is also retired, as a single AZ-103 exam is the singular path to earning the Microsoft Certified Azure Administrator Associate certification. For those of you who are early achievers out there, I understand this may be a bit frustrating for you, but this change will simplify the certification process to attain it and is a good change to be made, right? Next is why you should opt for AZ-103 certification. So today, Microsoft Azure Administrator is ruled out to be one of the most esteemed job titles in the cloud industry. How? Since Azure is one of the pioneers in providing the cloud services and it has got majority of its shares in the cloud market worldwide after AWS, which means greater job opportunities, and no doubt it is being majorly used by majority of the Fortune 500 companies. Moreover, Azure Administrator profile guarantees attractive pay packages along with a solid career growth opportunities. According to the latest report, the average pay of an Azure Administrator ranges between $100,000 per annum, and an experienced Microsoft Azure Administrator can earn up to $120,000 per annum. So I guess this should be enough to satisfy a candidate who is willing to go for AZ-103 exam preparation. Moving forward, in order to be well prepared for AZ-103 exam, you must know that what are the prerequisites required for the exam, right? So you need to have at least intermediate server administration knowledge and skills, should have a basic knowledge of PowerShell, and a general familiarity with the cloud computing concepts. Now let's move forward and discuss about the exam objectives. So guys, due to constant feedbacks about the exam being difficult, Microsoft has divided the entire exam syllabus into 5 modules in order to ease the exam preparation. So let's discuss each of these modules below. Manage Azure subscriptions and resources. So this percentage figure that you see here basically indicates the relative weightage of the questions from each of the modules. If the percentage is higher, then you should expect more questions from that module and vice versa. So guys, in this module, you need to be thoroughly prepared with managing Azure subscriptions, resource groups, analyzing resource utilization and consumption, and managing role-based access control. Second, implement and manage storage, where it holds a weightage of 15 to 20% in an exam, covering the topics like creation and configuration of storage accounts, Azure files, importing and exporting data to Azure, and implementing Azure backups. Third is deploying and managing virtual machines, holding a weightage from 15 to 20%, covering topics in creation and configuration of virtual machines for Windows and Linux, managing Azure virtual machines, and automating their deployments and managing their backups. Fourth one is configure and manage virtual networks, which holds a majority of weightage around 30 to 35% and covering topics in create connectivity between virtual networks, implementing and managing virtual networking, network security groups, Azure load balancer, monitoring and troubleshooting virtual networks, integrating on-premises network with Azure virtual network. Fifth and the last one is manage identities, holding a weightage from 15 to 20% in the exam. So managing Azure Active Directory and Active Directory objects, users, groups and devices, implementing and managing hybrid identities and multi-factor authentication are being covered in this module. Now let's move forward and discuss about the exam pattern. No doubt the AZ-103 exam is one of the most challenging exams in the IT industry, right? Although the number of questions in this exam are subject to change over time. You can expect around 40 to 60 questions in this exam, and also you can expect different questions formats and tie-ups in this exam, including review screen, mock review, multiple choices, short answers, hot area, repeated answer choices, drag and drop, case studies, the best answer, and active screen. All the questions in this exam can follow any of these question types. You will get around 150 minutes to complete the examination with an additional 30 minutes of sitting time. For good results in the exam, it is required to follow the weight associated with each exam module during your AZ-103 exam preparation. The pricing depends on which location you are taking your exam from. For example, if you're taking your exam in US, then it is going to cost you around $165. But if you're taking it in India, then you will have to pay an amount of 4,800 Indian rupees. And the pricing is subject to change without a notice from country to country. As the pricing does not include applicable taxes, you need to confirm with your examination provider for an exact fee. If you're a student, then you can get a fee deduction in the exam if you can submit your valid educational credentials. Moreover, Microsoft Partner Network Program member, Microsoft Trainers, and Academy Program members are also eligible for reduced pricing. So guys, most of the technical questions require a passing score of 700. AZ-103 is not an exception. Any score greater or equal to 700 will be marked as passed. Otherwise, it will be marked as failed. Most of the short questions in this exam are one-pointer. If any question is worth more than that, then it will be indicated in the exam part itself. Also note that there are no penalty for an incorrect answer. The exam is available only in English language. Now we know of the examination pattern. Now let's discuss few other tips for the preparation of the exam. How to prepare for AZ-103 exam. The first step is to plan the module structure and study accordingly. For example, if you're going to implement Azure Backup, then you must also know about how to create and configure the storage accounts along with configuration of Azure files, right? So that you know the basics of implementing the configurations and storage accounts, right? You would require a lot of AZ-103 questions and verified study materials in order to earn good passing scores, right? You can refer to the official curriculum and study guide to plan your module study and get the right information. After that, practice sample test online. Once gained enough knowledge with this, then you should be able to step up into the next part of practicing hands-on, and this is the most crucial part in your learning journey. You can easily perform hands-on in Azure services since Azure provides a free tier option for newbies, and you get a $300 of credit in your Azure account once you're signed, which is valid for almost a year. Practicing hands-on will not only help you in cracking the exam, but it will also get you ready for your future job roles. In addition to that, check for the online training so that in case you have queries related to the subject, you can clear them right away, and experts' help is always recommended. Last but not the least, join the forums related to Microsoft Azure and search for questions related to your subject and check out the questions asked by the other people and go through the answers posted by the audience itself. It will always be helpful for you. Last suggestion from my end is that go for dumps only when you are thorough with the subject. You might be able to clear the exam and get certification from it, but believe me guys, you won't be job ready, as during the interview, without the practical approach, you won't be able to crack it or be able to answer the questions asked by the interviewer because you took the shortcut to get certified, right? So beware of the shortcuts, do a thorough study with the proper implementations in Azure and rise up in your career path. Now, you might be wondering how to take time for all this research and study. That is why we at Intellipaat are here for you. We understand that US professionals face problems to take time out for skilling up from your personal life. That is why we have done all the hard work for you and have come up with a comprehensive course on AZ-103 certification exam. If you're interested, then you can go through the course details with the link provided in the description box. I hope this video was helpful for you. See you next time.